fabulous job running our tech show. I am Allison Miller, and I was working with our tech crew to get all of the mics here, and Robert Purnell is getting all the, she helped to organize getting the costumes and sets and everything and makeup on, and then all your wonderful children and friends are amazing actors. So we are extremely lucky to have everybody work so hard in this production, and we're really lucky to have you at our seats. If your cell phones are on, just double check that they are on vibrate. I forgot to say that last night, we didn't have a single issue. So I think without further ado, we will start our actors' nightmare.
Extraordinary how pittance cheap music is. What?
Extraordinary how potent cheap music is.
Yes, that's true. Am I supposed to be Hamlet?
Who's got? Do you think that is?
Where?
The Duke of Westminster, I expect. Always is.
Ah, well, perhaps. To be or not to be? I don't know any more of it!
George, please, we're on our honeymoons.
Are we?
Yes, me with Victor and you with Sybil.
Ah.
Tell me about Sybil.
I've never met her.
George, you're so amusing. You're married to Sybil. Tell me about her.
Nothing much to tell.
Victor's like that too. I bet you were just about to tell me that you've traveled around the world.
Yes, I was. I traveled around the world.
How was it?
Oh, very nice.
I always feared the Taj Mahal would look like a biscuit box. Did it?
Not really.
I always feared the Taj Mahal would look like a biscuit box. Did it?
Hard to say. What a brand new biscuit box.
I always feared the Taj Mahal would look like a biscuit box. Did it? Did it?
I wonder whose yacht that is out there.
Did it? Did it? Did it?
Oh my, this balcony looks dusty. I think I'll just clean it up a little.
Not only did the Taj Mahal look like a biscuit box, but women should be struck regularly by gongs.
China.
China?
You traveled around the world? How was China?
I liked it, but I felt homesick.
How was China?
Lots of rice. Yeah, women by their feet.
How was China?
I hated it. I missed you.
How was China?
I hated it. I missed Sybil.
How was China?
I missed the maid, old maid.
There you are, just a moment, please. I think you missed the spot right here.
How was China?
Very large, China.
In Japan?
Very small, Japan.
And Ireland.
Very green.
And Iceland.
Very white.
And Sybil.
What?
Do you love Sybil?
Who's Sybil?
Oh, Elliot, you're so amusing. You make me laugh all the time. So, do you love Sybil?
Probably. I married her.
Oh, Elliot, darling, I'm sorry. We're mad to have left each other. Kiss me. Oh, how ghastly. Oh, this must be Sybil.
Oh, how ghastly. What shall we do with this Amanda? Oh, Elliot, she's simply obnoxious.
How rude.
Elliot, how can you treat me like this?
Hello, Sybil?
Since you asked, I'm very upset. I was writing a letter to your mother and wanted to know how to spell apothecary.
A-P-O-T-H-E-C-A-R-Y. Thank you. Don't scribble, Sybil.
Am I deceiving you? Are you kissing my husband a moment ago?
We must all speak in low tones and attempts to be civilized.
I was speaking in a low voice.
Yes. I can still hear you.
Sorry.
use Amanda. I think that's what he does in the play.
Very well. I can accept defeat gracefully. But I hope that when you find me hanging from the hopeful chandelier with my eyes open, bows down and my tongue hanging out, that you'll be very, very sorry. Goodbye.
What a dreadful spot she is.
Poor Sybil, she's gonna hang herself.
Oh, who cares? Who's got, do you think that is?
The Duke of Westminster, I expect.
How dare you mention that title to me! Oh, darling, I'm sorry. I love you madly.
I inhaled your cigar.
Lying! F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T. Oh, get in? Okay. This must be one of those modern day Hamlets.
Nothing to be done. Pause. Wrinkle nose. Nothing to be done.
I guess you're not Ophelia.
Well, just wait. Pause. Neither shall come. Pause. Pause. Or she won't.
That's a reasonable attitude. Are we, I guess, waiting for Godot?
No, Willie. He came already with an awful bark. Yesterday he came with garlic on his bed, telling a lot of unpleasant jokes. Ugh, you're just dreadful. Pause. Rolls her eyes upward.
I'm sorry to hear that. Pause. So, who are we waiting for?
We're waiting for Lefty.
Ah, and is he a political organizer or something, I seem to recall?
Yes, dear, he's a political organizer. He's always coming around saying, get involved, get off your behinds, fight the system, this, that. Oh, you're just exhausting. Pause. Makes left eyes. Makes right eye. Closes eyes. Opens them.
So we're not really waiting for anybody then, are we?
No, dear. It's just another happy day. Pause. Smile. Wrinkle nose.
Do you smell something?
It's not your mind, Willie. Willie doesn't have that many lines. Oh, Willie, how talkative you are today.
There seems to be some sort of a muck at the bottom of this garbage can.
There's a muck at the bottom of everyone's garbage can. Count your blessings, Willie. I do. One, two, three. Are you counting, Willie?
I guess so.
Good. I'm up to three. Three's for my eyesight.
Oh my God! I've gone blind! I can't see anything! Oh my God!
Oh well. It's not so bad, Willie. I only use my eyes occasionally when I want to see something. But no more.
I really don't know this play at all.
Count your blessings, Willie. Let me hear you count them.
Okay. One, two, three. That's my eyesight. Four. Well, that's my hearing. Five. Well, that's my MasterCard. Six.
Did you say five, Willie?
No.
Why did you leave the monastery? Was it the same reason I left the opera?
I have no idea.
Well, I left the opera because I couldn't sing. They were meant to have hired me. Tries to touch her nose with her tongue.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please?
Willie, a voice? Perhaps there is a God.
At this evening's performance, the role of Sir Thomas More, the man for all seasons, normally played by Edwin Booth, will be played by George Spelvin. The role of Lady Alice, normally played by Sarah Bernhardt, will be played by Sarah Siddons. The role of Lady Margaret, normally played by Eleonora Dews, will be read by the stage manager. And at this evening's performance, the executioner will play himself.
What did he just say?
The executioner will play himself.
What does he mean, the executioner will play himself? Yes, thank you.
Oh, Father, if you don't give in to King Henry now, they're going to cut your head off.
Aren't you going to eat? We have to have what you
No, thank you. I'm not hungry.
Oh my god, I've got to get out of here!
You know right there, you'll never get into the cave.
No, no, I might. Quick, is this all about animal in it, everything?
Yes, and you won't give in because you believe in the Catholic Church and the infallibility of the Pope and the everlasting life of a soul.
Now, I don't necessarily believe in any of that. Oh, sir, there's been an error. I think it's fine if the king marries Amblin. I just want to wake up!
Oh, don't deny God, Father. Just a spare of feelings. Mother and I will just have you dead. It's a question of principle.
Now, look, I don't think the Pope is infallible at all. I think he's a normal man with normal capabilities who wears gold slippers.
Oh, I was having such a pleasant dream. Go ahead. Let you put your hat off. It will be a nice change of pace.
That play looks very real to me. I want to wake up now. Or change plays. I wonder who the odd man is out there. No, thank you.
Sir Thomas More, you have been found guilty by the charge of high treason. Sentence of the court that you'll be taken to the Tower of London, sent to the place of execution, and there your head shall be stricken off your body. May God have mercy on your soul.
All this talk about God! All right, fine. I'm sorry I didn't join the monastery after high school. Maybe I should have. And I'm sorry I giggled during Mass in third grade, but I see no reason to be killed for it.
Nothing to be done. That's why I find so wonderful about it.
No!
Why, here you're right. You wish to change your previous stand against King Henry's marriage to Anne.
Yes. Yes, God, yes, I could care less. Let him marry eight wives.
That's a terrible legacy.
I don't care!
I'm going to ignore what you just said and cut your head off anyway. After all, the person you claim is going to turn in these years to look upon you. Don't you agree?
I agree. I know I need someone to look up to.
Wait. Yes, I can feel myself waking up now.
Sir Thomas, prepare to meet your death.
Shh! Be quiet, I'm about to wake up.
Sir Thomas, prepare to meet your death.
I'm awake! No, I'm not!
Sir Thomas, prepare to meet your death.
Line! Line!
He doesn't know his lines. You turn to the executioner and say, friend, be not afraid of their office. Send me to God.
I don't like that line. Give me another.
That's the line of the scripture. Say it!
I don't want to!
Say it! Say it, Lily. It will mean a lot to me and to generations of school children to come.
Say it!
Friend, be not afraid of your office. You send me extraordinary help on the sheep using me.
That's not the line.
I wonder whose job that is out there.
Say the line, right, George.
Well, they say that you can never dream your own death. So I suppose I'll wake up just as soon as he starts to break the axe down. So I suppose I better get this over with.
Say the line right.
Friend, be not afraid of your office.
Goodbye, Lily.
Goodbye, Hamlet. Goodbye, George.
Goodbye, Sir Thomas.
You sent me to God.
Behold, the head of Sir Thomas More.